Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on hormonal regulation of the female reproductive cycle. Now, when you are preparing this topic, what you should be looking at. So, in female reproductive system, four hormones are involved basically, and these four hormones are playing the key role in the development of female reproductive system. Now, these hormones are: number one, estrogen; second one is progesterone; third one is relaxin; and the fourth one is inhibin. Now, in my previous lecture of follicular development, I have explained you how this estrogen is produced. So if you haven't seen it, please go through that lecture, so you will get the idea that how this estrogen is produced. Now, for this lecture, I would only say that from the granulosa cell of the follicle, this estrogen is produced, and after the ovulation, that means when the graafian follicle ruptures, the cells, the granulosa cell and the theca cells of graafian follicle, from these two cells, the endocrine structure that is formed is known as corpus luteum. So here you have to remember, estrogen is produced by the granulosa cell of the follicle and by the corpus luteum. Okay, so here as you can see, there are 1, 2, 3, and 4 hormones, which are the structure that are producing this hormone, and what are the function of this hormone, that you need to know. Okay, so one by one I am discussing all the hormones. Okay, first hormones that I am going to discuss with you is estrogen. Now, as you can see over here, it is written. So in female plasma, that means in the blood of girls and women, there are 6 different type of estrogens are present. Okay, and the estrogens which are present in significant quantities are beta, estradiol, estrone, and estriol. Okay, and in non-pregnant woman, the most abundant estrogen is beta estradiol, and this beta estradiol is synthesized from the cholesterol in the ovaries. Okay, now this estrogen, what is the role of this estrogen? So now, as we know, this estrogen is secreted by the granulosa cell of ovarian follicle and also by the corpus luteum. So what is the role of this estrogen in female body? Okay, so estrogen promotes and develops and also maintains the female reproductive structures. Okay, that means the vagina, okay, then uterus, oviduct, and ovary. So all these organs, in the development of all this organ, estrogen play a vital role. That is the meaning of this thing. Then estrogen is also responsible for the development of secondary sex characteristic. Estrogen is also involved in the development of breast. Okay, now which are the secondary sex characteristics of the female? So So the secondary sex characteristic include, okay. So estrogen is involved in the distribution of adipose tissue. So in adipose tissue is a type of connective tissue, and in which lipids predominantly the lipid is present. Okay, so in the breast, okay, more and more adipose tissue is deposited. Okay, so due to the effect of estrogen, the breast size increases. Okay, in abdomen, the adipose tissue is distributed. Okay, then in mons pubis, in hips. Okay, so in all these organs, this adipose tissue is distributed, it is deposited. The proportion of adipose tissue increases in all these organs. Okay, so all these organs, are developing, they are developed due to the estrogen. Okay, then the voice quality, okay, voice pitch, okay, the voice quality, the softer voice of females, for that estrogen is responsible. Okay, females have broader pelvis, so estrogen is responsible for the broader pelvis. Okay, and the growth of hair, okay, on the body, so for the growth of hair, estrogen is responsible. Okay, then estrogen increases protein anabolism. Now protein anabolism means the synthesis of protein. Okay, now you have to understand this point. Estrogen increases the protein anabolism means estrogen increases the protein synthesis process in the females. Now that's why it is very important for all the girls and women to be indulged in various exercises. All the girls and women in the daily routine, they should be performing moderate amount of weight training, right? So that's why it will be help to develop their muscles. And when the muscles, when they are performing the exercises, what will happen? Due to the exercise in the muscle, protein synthesis will take place, and this protein synthesis will require estrogen. So if the girls and women, they are performing moderate to light exercise with the weights at home or at gym, so in their body the amount of estrogen will be maintained, okay, or it will be increased. Okay, because estrogen in female body, estrogen is the key. Okay, the entire beauty of the girls and women rely on the amount of estrogen. That is the role that estrogen is playing. Okay, now then the development of the strong bones, for the development of strong bones, estrogen is required. Okay, so we can say the estrogen is playing a similar role that of human growth hormone, that is HGH. Okay, then in this point, okay, woman under 50, so you will never heard that the woman age 45, okay, got the heart attack. The reason is estrogen lowers blood cholesterol level. Okay, so in the coronary artery, which is the main artery of the heart, okay, so cholesterol is not deposited. That's why women are at a very lower risk for getting the heart attack. Okay, so the reason is the estrogen is lowering the blood cholesterol level. Okay, then this point, then the last point for the estrogen. Okay, this point is negative feedback. Okay, this is the negative feedback mechanism for the estrogen. Okay, so one chart I am showing you for this. Okay, inhibitory action of estrogen. Okay, so I will show you this chart. So over here they are showing, for example, this is the corpus luteum. Okay, now we know how this corpus luteum, if you have gone through my lecture of luteal phase of the ovarian cycle, so you will be having the idea that the how this corpus luteum is developed, okay, after the process of ovulation. Now this corpus luteum is secreting, we know this four hormones are secreted by corpus luteum, but over here we are focusing on the estrogen. Okay, so estrogen is produced by corpus luteum. Now what this estrogen is doing, so this estrogen is negatively affecting the anterior pituitary, and estrogen is also having negative feedback on hypothalamus. So due to the negative feedback of estrogen, hypothalamus will produce lesser amount of GnRH. So now we know this GnRH affects the cells of anterior pituitary. Okay, so this cells of anterior pituitary, they will secrete lesser amount of LH and FSH. Okay, so this point, this is the negative feedback of estrogen, that this point you have to remember. Okay, from corpus luteum estrogen is produced and it is having a negative feedback effect on anterior pituitary as well as hypothalamus. So with this we have completed the effect, all the effect of estrogen, what is the role of estrogen is playing in female's body. Okay, now the second hormone. Okay, once again, this second hormone, that is the progesterone. So progesterone, once again, it is secreted, it is produced mainly by corpus luteum. Okay, now this progesterone, what is the role of this progesterone? Okay, so as it is written over here, progesterone along with estrogen prepares and maintains the endometrium for the implantation of fertilized ovum. Okay, now what is the meaning of this? I am explaining you. Over here, as you can see, this is the ovary. Okay, and after the process of ovulation, this one is the secondary oocyte is released. Now this secondary oocyte is traveling in the fallopian tube. Okay, now at the time of ovulation, if the sexual intercourse is performed, so from the semen, the sperms will be traveling via this route. Okay, from the uterus they are traveling all this way. Okay, and here as you can see the sperms are shown. Okay, so this secondary oocyte is surrounded by this sperm. Okay, and this secondary oocyte is fertilized. Okay, so this is now a secondary oocyte will be converted into zygote after fertilization. Okay, now this zygote is start dividing. So as you can see here, this is start dividing, two cells are there, then the four cells, okay, then eight. Okay, so 1 minute, sorry for this, I got the call. But here so we were discussing this, two cells, then the four cells, then the eight cells. Okay, and here so 2, 4, 8, 16, okay, more and more cells. Okay, so finally then this is the blastocyte. Okay, blastocyte is produced. So this blastocyst is produced after the fertilization. This blastocyst is formed after 4.5 to 5 days, and this is the developing embryo, and this embryo needs to be implanted over here. Okay, so this is the uterus, this one is the uterus, and this uterus, we have divided the wall of uterus in 3 layers. Okay, so outer one, that is perimetrium, the middle one, myometrium, and the inner wall of uterus is known as endometrium. Okay, so if this entire fertilization is taking place, then this early embryo in its development stage, so this early embryo needs to be implanted over here. Okay, so when this embryo is going to be implanted, that time, so for example, this is the endometrium. Okay, that time this endometrium needs to be very vascularized. It should be very thick, and two hormones, one is progesterone and second one, you have to remember, estrogen. So this two hormone prepares endometrium so that this embryo can be implanted. Okay, so this is the role of progesterone prepares the endometrium for the implantation. This point you need to remember. This is the one function of progesterone. Okay, then the second function of progesterone. Okay, now development of mammary gland and milk secretion. Okay, I am showing you this. I am rolling the slide and I am showing you. For example, these are the mammary gland. Okay, this one and this one. Okay, so progesterone affect the mammary gland. Okay, and as you can see, these are the milk secreting epithelial cell. Okay, in the mammary gland, so progesterone effect on this cell, and this cell, as you can see, these white drops. Okay, so this is milk. Okay, so we can say the alveoli is affected by progesterone, and the cells of alveoli, this epithelial cell, they are producing milk. Okay, so this entire structure, this is the mammary gland. So development of mammary gland, for that progesterone is responsible, and for the milk secretion. Okay, as you can see, this baby is sucking the milk from the mammary gland. So for the nourishment of the baby, the milk is produced, and in this milk secretion, in this milk production, this progesterone is also very important. Okay, and these, now the final effect of the progesterone that I am going to show you, the negative feedback. So once again, as you can see, corpus luteum is producing progesterone, and this progesterone is negatively feedbacking the anterior pituitary. Okay, progesterone negatively feedbacks the anterior pituitary, and this progesterone is also negative feedbacking on hypothalamus. So due to the effect of progesterone, once again, this hypothalamus is secreting lesser amount of GnRH. okay, so since the GnRH is present in less amount, So this anterior pituitary will secrete the less amount, anterior secretory will produce the lesser amount of LH. So this point you have to remember. So three function of progesterone I have explained to you. Okay, then we are moving on the third hormone. Okay, do you remember the all four names? Okay, first was estrogen, second was progesterone, that we have completed. Okay, the function of estrogen, function of progesterone. Now the third hormone in female reproductive system, that is relaxin. Okay, so as the name suggests, relaxin. Okay, first point, from where this relaxin is produced? Okay, which structure is producing this relaxin? So what, one, two names you have to remember. One one name, corpus luteum. Okay, corpus luteum is producing relaxin, and the second structure, that is placenta. Okay, now again we have to understand this, why corpus luteum is producing relaxin and why this placenta is producing relaxin. Okay, so I am explaining both the effect of relaxin, which is produced, one which is produced by corpus luteum and one which is produced by placenta, and what is the role of this relaxin. Okay, so once again I am showing you this over here. Now this is the wall of uterus, and in this wall perimetrium is there, this is a myometrium, and this one is a endometrium. Okay, now as you know, this is myometrium, this one is a myometrium. Okay, this is the myometrium, and myometrium, as you know, myometrium is made up of smooth muscle. Okay, so from corpus luteum, relaxin is produced, and this relaxin is affecting this myometrium. Okay, now myometrium is affected by relaxin, so this relaxin is basically is inhibiting the contraction of the smooth muscle of myometrium. But why this relaxin is inhibiting the contraction of myometrium, that is the question. Now you have to understand, this one is the secondary oocyte. Okay, if the sperms are present, fertilization is taking place, 2 cell 4 cell. Okay, so early embryo, and early embryo is going to be implanted on endometrium, and just beneath the endometrium myometrium is present. And imagine if relaxin is not secreted by corpus luteum, so that time what will happen? Okay, so if relaxin is not present, then this contraction of myometrium will be taking place. Okay, and this contraction will affect the endometrium, so endometrium will be also contracting. So it will not possible this embryo to implant on this endometrium, and that's why it is very important to relax this myometrium. Okay, so that is the meaning of that is the role of that relaxin is playing. Okay, then now, so we can say the relaxin keep quiet or keep silent the uterus, and that is the role of relaxin. Okay, that this thing you have to remember. Okay, now during the pregnancy, from the placenta, this relaxin is secreted in a tremendous amount. Okay, so because the baby's body is developing over here, okay, so that time this relaxin, which is produced by placenta, it relaxes this myometrium, the smooth muscles of myometrium, they remain in a relaxed mode. Okay, they are not contracting. So the 9 month pregnancy, during this 9 month pregnancy, they are not contracting. Okay, imagine if this myometrium is contracting, then what will happen? So there are the chances that the miscarriage can happen, right? So that's why the development of the baby, and if the miscarriage should not occur, so that's why this relaxin relaxes this myometrium. Okay, that is the role of relaxin. Okay, then so once again, so 2 points for the relaxin I have covered. Then the third point of the relaxin that I am explaining, okay, as you can see, at the end of pregnancy, this relaxin also increases the flexibility of the pubic symphysis, okay, and dilate the uterine cervix. Now what is the meaning of this? Flexibility, once again, you remember this, flexibility of the pubic symphysis is increased by relaxin at the end of pregnancy and dilate the uterine cervix. Now what is the meaning of this? I am showing you this with the figure, you will be able to understand this point. I am showing you the figure. Okay, so 1 minute. Here the figure. Okay, as you can see, I am decreasing the size of figure so that you can see this. Okay, as you can see, in the womb, in the uterus, the baby's body, this one, baby's body is shown. Okay, so at the end of pregnancy, this baby is going to born. Okay, so mother is about to give the birth. Okay, so the hormone relaxin, this is the, as you can see, this one, pubic symphysis, you just follow the arrow where this arrow is going. So this one is the pubic symphysis. Okay, and what is the role of relaxin? So from placenta relaxin is produced, and this relaxin is increasing the flexibility of pubic symphysis. So this pubic symphysis becomes more flexible. Okay, and this, you can see, this is the head of the baby. Okay, it is very close to this pubic symphysis. Then another point, dilate uterine cervix. So relaxin dilating. Now you know the cervix is a narrow part of uterus. Okay, so, and this one is the head of baby, okay? And when the baby is going to born, the first body part that is coming out from the vagina is the head, generally, okay? If it is a normal delivery, in that case, so the relaxin dilates the cervix of uterus, okay? So we can say the relaxin is broadening the passage of cervix. So this entire body of the baby can easily comes out, you know, from uterus. Then it will enter the body, the body of baby will enter from uterus to cervix, and then from vagina the entire baby will come out, okay? So this is the role of relaxin, okay? So it is also dilating the cervix, okay? Now the last hormone, okay, three hormone we have completed, and the last hormone, okay? So last hormone is inhibin, okay? It is secreted by granulosa cell of growing follicle and corpus luteum after ovulation. Inhibin is secreted by granulosa cell of the follicle, and after ovulation it is secreted by corpus luteum. Inhibin, again negative feedback, the same chart I will show you. This was the chart, okay? As you can see, from corpus luteum inhibin is produced, and it is negatively feedbacking anterior pituitary, and also negative feedbacking on hypothalamus. So due to the negative feedback of inhibin, hypothalamus will produce lesser amount of GnRH, and GnRH since the amount of GnRH is reduced, so this anterior pituitary will secrete the lesser amount of FSH and LH, okay? So with this I have completed all four hormones of female reproductive system, okay? At this point this lecture is over, but what I am going to do now is I am showing you one by one all the slides, okay? So you can take the screenshot and you can prepare your notes. So these are all the information you should be having with you, so you can take the screenshot. This is very important chart at the time of your examination. Quickly you can go through this chart and you can prepare for all the hormones, okay? Then this information I will keep it like this, so that you can take the screenshot, okay? Then this progesterone on left hand side, all the information is written, all four, okay? So this is the theory part, and this topic, follicular development, this is the follicular development topic, but you go through this lecture also so that you can understand how this estrogen is produced. In detail I have explained entire mechanism. Then this is very good, this you can take. Then this chart for the negative, with this simple chart on the right hand side you will get the idea, okay? There is three hormones, how they are negative feedbacking, the hypothalamus and anterior pituitary, okay? Then the role of progesterone. One minute. as you can see on the development of mammary gland, progesterone, okay, then in the milk production, the progesterone, then from this figure you will get the idea, okay, from corpus luteum relaxin is produced after ovulation, and at the end of pregnancy from the placenta relaxin is produced, and these are the roles of relaxin hormone. What is the function of relaxin? Okay, so this way you can take the screenshot, you go through this, you read this information. Okay, this figure, this is the final figure, I guess, this one. Okay, and this is how, okay, the relaxin, as you can see, this is the very very narrow passage. Okay, so this is the this portion is known as cervix, and it is a narrow passage, and this head is going to come out from the, this is from the vagina. Okay, so relaxin is dilating this cervix. Okay, so this is how the baby is born. Okay, so this process of birth, parturition, it refers, baby's birth is known as parturition in biology. Okay, so this is the stage one of dilation. Okay, cervix is dilated, the head is coming out, okay, and the entire baby came out. Okay, so this is about how this graafian follicle ruptures, how this corpus luteum is produced. Okay, and this part. Okay, so with this I am completing this presentation lecture. I hope you have enjoyed this lecture. My name is Manish Koshti sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye bye. Namaste.